Hey, what's up? John Sonmez from simpleprogrammer.com. So I got a question here specifically about the MCSD qualification and whether it's beneficial. And this question comes from Joy, and she says, is the Microsoft Certified Solutions Developer, MCSD, qualification beneficial in the long run? If so, do I need all of them to make it to the top? Additional info. She says, I'm a second year student at iStudent Academy, part-time intern junior programmer from South Africa. I've written the 480 and 70461 Microsoft exams. It takes up most of my time preparing to write. This is so heavy, I feel like I've got a lot of weight on my shoulders and I have no time in college. No time in college, I'm assuming she says. So I actually, some of you don't know this, but I actually have the MCSD certification. I got MCDBA, MCSE. I basically did all the Microsoft certifications way back in the day. And I did it for a couple of reasons. One of them was because I was sort of transitioning, trying to break into being a full-time developer, kind of transitioning between testing, and I wanted a way to prove that I knew what I was doing, that I was qualified, and I wanted to be able to advance, to be able to have something that other people didn't have, some kind of qualification that proved that I was willing to work hard, right? It wasn't necessarily about the knowledge, it was just that if I showed my boss, if I said, hey, look at all these certifications I got and look at the work that I did to get these, it shows that I'm motivated and I'm investing in my education and that I want to advance, and that is more impressive than the certification itself or the value from the certification. So that's what I would say with this is you have to be careful. You know, I've done a video on certifications before. You can check out, you know, is it worth getting a certification or whatever that video is called. But I want to talk specifically, I'll talk a little bit more about that in this case. So why are you getting the certification, right? What is your purpose, right? Is it because you think you're going to get a better job by having the certification? Is it because you think you're going to gain some knowledge by doing it? In my experience, certifications, they're similar to college degrees in the respect that they don't necessarily mean anything by themselves. I know plenty of people that have college degrees, especially MBAs, that don't know jack. They don't know jack about anything. And so, and it's not that you can't go to college or you can't get a certification and learn a lot. You can if you apply yourself and your goal is to learn. But you can also get the degree or get the certification without knowing anything. And a lot of intelligent people realize that. And so that sort of devalues the degree, but more so devalues the certification. But I'll tell you what a certification does tell you about a person. It says that, one, that they're trying, that they're serious, that they take their career seriously. It tells you that they can put their mind to a task and complete that task and succeed at it. And you've probably heard people say similar things about college, about getting a college degree. So the value of the certification is not in the certification itself. It's in the fact that you have moved, that you have taken steps, that you have completed something that is somewhat difficult and you have made it through, right? And you've invested in your career. That's the real value of it. So I think this is important to understand because it's how you present yourself, right? If you have a certification on your resume, it's honestly probably more likely to get looked at, but you're not going to get the job based on that certification alone. No one is going to say, oh, you're an MCSD? Oh, well, I got to hire you. I don't even need to interview you. That's not going to happen. But when you're in the interview and you talk about why you got the certification and what that means in the struggle that you went through and how you stuck with it and you got through it and what you learned along the way, that's where the value lies, right? So it's really up to you. You know, getting some people try to get all these certifications, they think it's a shortcut, especially in the IT world. I think people used to try to get the Cisco, you know, CNA certification and the A+ certification so they could work. And they think that's going to just get them a wonderful job. And that's not the case. It's not the case with MCSD. It's not the case with any certifications. The thing is that you've still got to learn. You've still got to have the ability. You've still got to have the skills. The certification is something that can enhance that and help you on top of that. The only exception to this, I would say, especially since you're asking specifically about this MCSD certification, is that if you want to get a company working for a consulting company or solution provider, they love those credentials, right? Because then they can say that our consultants are MCSD certified. In fact, some Microsoft consultants that specifically deal in Microsoft products, they won't even hire you, or as soon as you get hired, they'll require you to get that certification so that you can say that you are certified, because that looks good to their clients, right? So again, certifications to employers don't necessarily look so good, right? It's the same argument for a college, but to clients, and especially if you're a freelancer, then that can come into play, because that's a credential. That's why, you know, you see all these certifications for doctors or for lawyers or architects, right? It's not to get a job, right? Although it can help, but it's because clients like that, because that gives clients some amount of trust. And so there's definitely more value there. So, you know, like I said, if you're going to work for one of these consultancies, if that's your aim, then go ahead. Yeah, get the certification. It's going to be extremely valuable. But if you think you're going to get a job just on the value of the certification, it's not going to happen. But it's worthwhile to do, right? But don't stress yourself out so much. If you feel like it's too much and you can't do that with college, you know, finish the degree. Don't worry about the certification. Maybe you can do the certification later. But you know, you got to bounce it out, and you got to make a decision for yourself. If I look back at my own career, do I regret getting the certifications? No, they helped me a lot. Honestly, the biggest way that they helped me is that they made me distinct from everyone else, right? All my peers, they were, you know, at review time when they asked for promotion, they hadn't read 40 books in the last year. They hadn't gotten 5 certifications, right? Having all those things helped me to show that I was serious and I was dedicated and I was going to the top and you can't stop me. And that's why I did it. And that's the real value I got from that. It was really in that one instance. So anyway, great question. If you've got a question for me, you can always email me at john@simpleprogrammer.com. And if you like this video, I have a request for you, which is to click that subscribe button below. If you're already a subscriber, you know, a thumbs up and a like is always appreciated. And like, as always, you can share the video if you think it'll help someone who's worrying and stressing about certification. And I'll talk to you next time.